At the start of the week, the NT was experiencing its driest wet season to date. But with a deluge of rain over the past few days, we've now eclipsed the amount of rain that we had at the same time last season. And showers and thunderstorms have also brought heavy rain to northern Queensland. So there's been a lot of discussion around whether this is the monsoon or whether we're still waiting for the official onset. Now, Grace, if we look at the satellite imagery, we can see a vast area of shower and thunderstorms. So are we seeing the monsoon yet?
We have a definition in Darwin that we haven't quite met yet. We're looking at winds through a large depth of the atmosphere, and everything hasn't quite lined up, but it's certainly feeling that way as you see those showers and thunderstorms streaming through.
And if we have a look at the forecast for the next few days, we're seeing these westerly winds, and that's really what we're looking at, looking for, isn't it?
Yeah, with those westerlies, they come all the way from the equator and stream down, and that's what brings all that moisture with it.
And also, of course, with all the moisture and these winds converging, that's when we see the shower and thunderstorm activity. Now, when would we normally expect to see the onset of the monsoon?
For Darwin, the average time is around Christmas, so it is quite a late onset.
And actually, the latest onset that we've ever seen is the 25th of January back in 1973. So that just provides some context, considering it's the 23rd of January now, just how late it actually is. And now, obviously, expecting showers and thunderstorms, so how much rain can we expect over the coming days?
It will depend heavily on where this low is, but we could see areas all the way through the NT and into Queensland where we'd see heavy showers and thunderstorms, and could see isolated falls of around 100 millimetres.
And of course, with all the moisture and these converging winds, it is possible that we'll see some heavier falls of greater than 100 millimetres. And of course, that brings the threat of flooding with these very heavy falls expected across the north. So with flooding possible, please stay up to date with all the latest forecasts and warnings on the Bureau's website and app, and please follow all advice from local emergency services.